Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video from the SAVE, SIG P220 Legion chambered in 10mm. I noticed that I can't find... I did a video about this handgun, I believe, maybe 2 years ago. So I was thinking about doing a, you know, revisit on it, but I don't see that video up anymore. So I don't remember what happened. So I figured I'd grab this handgun out of the safe. We can do a video, I guess, fresh, but... if you, you know, follow me and you've seen the video already, then, well, this is a revisit video. So let's get right into this and check out this very fine, very cool 10mm handgun. But before we go on, I just want to say that a 10mm 1911 is just not for me. I gave up on those a couple of years ago, and I've owned quite a few 10mm 1911s from Dan Wesson's, you know, Razorback, Bruin, Kodiak, to Colt Delta Elites, new gen, old gen, to even a custom Nighthawk, you know, Nighthawk custom Predator that just never worked. It always failed to feed. I sent it back to Nighthawk 2 times and we just could not figure out the equation. It constantly failed to feed to the point I just gave up and sold it to somebody that said, I'll take on this problem and figure it out. And I know he went to his own gunsmith. And I don't know what happened. I don't know the guy, so he just told me he's going to go to his own gunsmith and get it figured out. So hopefully he has a very nice Predator 10mm that's working. Because when I owned it, it just never worked. I almost went to Wilson Combat to have them build me one. But I could tell, they were like, So I figured, all right, no, forget it. You know, if I get another Wilson, it's just going to be in 45. Possibly a 9mm, but I'm going to stick to 45 for my 1911s. So I no longer own a single 10mm 1911. The 10mm platforms that do work, that I, you know, what I found was, of course, the Glock Model 20. I still have one, although I haven't shot it in quite some time, a couple of years now. I have not been into the 10mm in a couple of years, although the 10mm cartridge is something that I really like. I've always liked the 10mm, but it has taken a large back seat because of my time with revolvers, okay, and then I was doing, you know, 1911s and 45, but I always liked the 10mm cartridge. But the platforms that I found that work very well has been the Glock Model 20. You know, that's enough said about that. Also, the... I don't own this one anymore. The Smith & Wesson 10mm 3rd Generation Auto, the FBI gun. That was an okay handgun, but I sold it at a premium because someone really wanted that gun so bad that, you know, I wasn't really shooting it. Didn't really have too much interest in it, so I got rid of it. It was an okay gun. It wasn't anything special to me, but I guess this one individual was willing to spend whatever he could to get it from me. So I said, that's fine. Business is business. So yeah, I that one worked just fine, but that gun was made, I think, in 1990. So it did show its age and a lot of wear. Other platforms would be, of course, the SIG. The SIG P220 chambered in 10mm has been 100% reliable for me. And this one right here is the Legion flavor, okay? I've owned this for quite some time. And... like I said, I've put tons of rounds through this. This is a DASA, all right, double action, first shot, single action, subsequent, just like that. So you need to decock it like that. All right, it has a single stack magazine. Oh no, not enough. 8 rounds plus 1, so you're gonna have 9 rounds in this gun. But this one here, full steel handgun, handles all these different 10mm cartridges very well. Recoil is manageable. It's snappy. But for me, it's not really a big deal at all. Now, mind you, I'm used to 500 Magnum, so shooting a 10mm is really nothing at all. But what I'm trying to say is, since this is a full steel handgun, the weight and the balance of this gun makes for that felt recoil to be not bad at all. The Glock Model 20, you'll feel it, and it flips up a little bit more, but... it's not, you know, not that big of a deal. But this one here is very, very controllable, and it's a very nice handgun. I like this more than the Glock Model 20. Of course I do, because of the way it looks. The way it looks, the way it feels, the way it handles, it's pretty much superior to the Glock Model 20. But if you are just getting into the 10mm platform, I mean, just go for a Glock Model 20. That's all I'll say. The other models, you know, like a Model 29, you know, that's going to be a bit snappy, and you're going to start feeling it like a J-frame in the palm of your hand. I used to have a Glock Model 29 years ago, and I carried one for, you know, a couple months, but ultimately I kind of just gave up on that. The long slide version, that actually, the long slide version, I did have a failure to feed, I think. I think that's what happened, only one, but that was a little bit different situation. But the Glock Model 20 itself, and I've owned different versions of it, it's been 100%. The SIG right here, 100%. Now, I used to own the SIG P220 Hunter, okay, which was camouflaged back in 2016, I think, and I never did a video about that handgun. That one worked just fine, but I didn't like the way it looked. I thought it looked ugly as hell, but I got it for at a heavily discounted price, and it was used, so I said, why not? And I shot it, you know, handful of times. I liked it, but like I said, I didn't like how it looked, and it had a rear adjustable sight, so I ended up selling that off in favor of this one here. It's just a standard old Legion. Now, the Legion has, you know, you can call it a performance center, you know, it might be a marketing type of deal when they call it a Legion, but it does have some little perks here and there, so we can kind of go through that right now quickly. I mean, it's a, like I said, it's a nice gun. So as you can see, it's got forward serrations on the slide right here. Okay. It's got these type of grips right here that are pretty nice. Checkering on the back, front strap checkering right here. It has some checkering on the trigger guard underneath and on the front. So that's kind of interesting, right? So you got some grippiness right there. It does have a 5-inch barrel, so it has a little bit longer barrel than the standard 45 version. It has some night sights that are pretty cool. It's got that front night sight that's got a green ring around the collar, green right there. And the rear is kind of subdued, okay, with some serrations. It picks up very nicely and very quickly. The other really cool thing about this handgun is the controls are very subdued, meaning that slide stop or slide release, whatever you want to call it, is very unobtrusive. It's out of the way, because when you do a thumbs forward, and this always happened to me with SIGs, especially back in the day in the early 2000s when I had to shoot a P229, they call it the Legacy now, I constantly had that slide locked back prematurely, and it always annoyed me, and I didn't like that gun, but I had to carry that gun. But this one here, it's a different design. See how the footprint is just so like out of the way. So you're not gonna have that issue with having the slide inadvertently get locked back or, you know, prematurely locked back on you. What else we got going on here? The trigger system, I guess they're saying, is a little bit different. Honestly, it is a nice trigger, but I don't know. It doesn't feel that like, wow, it's, you know, so much different, but they're saying it has like a, I don't know, a polished action with that SRT short reset trigger system going on. I do feel that, okay? But, I don't know, it's still pretty, well, it's just double action first shot right here. Feels like a revolver, okay? Reset. Yeah, it's a short reset trigger. And the single action, of course, is very nice. I don't know. It's fine. It's got the rail here for your accessories. It's pretty nice. So you can have a light going on down there. Oh, that's what they call it. X-ray sights. Is that what it's called? So those are really nice. I like how the sights are. And the barrel hood, you can see some wear going on because this thing has had well over 1,000 rounds of 10mm ammunition. I actually have quite a bit of 10mm ammo on hand. So this gun has seen a lot of underwood. And it's been fine. It's functioned flawlessly. You know, I got a massive amount of 10mm, all from back in the day, Underwood stuff, and Buffalo Bore, Hornady. Okay, so much so, I actually gave away a lot of 10mm for free to somebody that kind of pissed me off because they were ungrateful. And I believe they ended up selling the ammunition, so that pissed me off, you know. That's happened to me a couple times before where I would give people ammo and they would sell it. You know, I don't know. I was trying to be nice, and I find out that they were selling the stuff that I gave them. I think one person I gave a Milt Sparks holster to, you know, hey, whatever, and they put it on eBay and they you know, banked on that pretty big. But Yeah, whatever. So I don't want to get off on that tangent. That could be a whole story time about stuff that I've given to other gun people and they ended up reselling it behind my back and making a huge profit. That goes with guns too. Like I would hook up people with guns and I would find out they would sell it at a crazy price. I'm like, what the hell? You know, I was doing a favor, but okay. That's how it is. But anyways, very nice handgun. Like I said, this thing has been 100%. Now, I have talked to somebody that said their frame did crack somewhere on their P220 10mm, so I don't know about that. You can do your own research. All I can say is with mine, it's been just fine. This one here, when did I get this? A while ago, and like I said, it's had a lot of rounds through it, and it still looks pretty good, except for that barrel hood, but that's where the lockup occurs on SIGs. But other than that, I mean, look at this thing. It looks pretty nice. I mean, I don't carry this thing. I never have carried it. But it's been shot quite a bit. I've let other people shoot this one. This is the gun I'll take out if someone's interested in 10mm. I'll take out the Glock Model 20 and this one. And for the most part, everybody grabs this one because it just looks cooler. And they like the way it feels in the hand. The Glock, you know, feels okay in the hand. It's plastic, you know, but it's the grip for some reason feels fatter, a little strange. And it flips up more because it's got the plastic frame, polymer frame. But this one here is highly controllable. And I think it's the way it looks. And that's why so many people grab this one. And I like it too. I actually do not have a holster for this. I used to. I think it was made by Mitch Rosen. But I actually gave it to someone else that actually carried this gun. Because I said I'd never carry this gun. And I think it's kind of difficult to find a concealment or any type of holster for this model with the 5-inch barrel and the rail. So you might have to go the custom route if you want to carry something like this. I talked to someone that carries this on in a chest rig because they use it as bear defense, which is fine. You know, 10mm will, you know, should do the job. I just like revolvers. But yeah, I mean, holster-wise might be a challenge to find something that will fit this. Or you might have to get a universal type of holster. So ammunition, this stuff here, made by Buffalo Bore, 180 grain heavy, 10mm. I have put, you know, like 3 boxes of this stuff through this with no problem. The spring in here is very, very strong, for sure, very strong. When you take this thing down, you can tell it's a different recoil spring setup. So this stuff has been through this in a lot of underwood. Now this one here is a full metal jacket. So it's mainly this stuff, target ammo right here, is what I put in here. This is some, as you can tell, this is a older underwood because that's what I got from a couple of years ago. A ton of this stuff, so much. And this here is just this is almost like 40 Smith & Wesson. This is nothing really, you know. I guess if you're going to carry this on the streets, maybe load it up with this. The 10mm duty, critical duty load, 175 grain flex lock, but this is a kind of a low powered 10mm, like 40 Smith and Week, Smith and Wesson. This I have a bunch of just because someone had it. This is from back in the day, I believe. Winchester Super X, got this from someone or somebody that had, it was their father that had a ton of ammo, and it's just leftover stuff. So, but anyways, just wanted to show this gun to you. It's very nice. I will try to do some range time shorts with this, but if you're looking for a 10mm handgun, this is something that you definitely should be looking for. I don't know what the pricing is on something like this nowadays. I'll have to admit it. I didn't pay anywhere near an MSRP price for this handgun, but I think the pricing of this went way up, if I'm not mistaken. So, you know, you got your Glock Model 20 for like $600. I think this is well over $1,300 now, or $1,500 now. That's quite a bit, but it is a very fine handgun, and you won't be sorry if you get this as your primary 10mm handgun. I don't know if you want to carry this concealed. It's a bit heavy, but you can try, you know, get a custom rig inside the waistband. Might work. These grips here are incredibly aggressive, though. These scales on here, but it'll work. Very nice handgun. All right, guys, just wanted to do a video about this fine 10mm handgun, and there you go. So you can leave some comments below. Let me know what you think, right? And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.